let's walk through an example of how Script works under the hood. So the example we're looking at the top of the screen is a script that specifies the most common type of transaction in Bitcoin, which is to redeem a previous transaction output. To redeem this previous transaction output, we need to provide our identities with, first, a public key that, when hashed, yields the address to which the previous transaction was sent. And second, a signature that proves ownership of the private key corresponding to the public key we provided. And this is the most common type of script in Bitcoin. It is called P2PKH hash, or it could be also shorthanded as P2PKH. But how do we actually implement this functionality? With unlocking and locking scripts. Unlocking scripts are scripts that you provide in your input when you want to spend from a previous transaction, allowing you to redeem the associated UTXOs. You provide the signature and your public key, which are needed to prove your identity and to unlock the transaction output. Your public key is then hashed and checked against the address that owns the UTXO. Because you provided a signature, the script is called scriptsig. On the other hand, locking scripts are scripts that are found in previous transaction outputs. The locking scripts specify the requirements for redeeming an UTXO. This essentially locks down the UTXO so it can only be spent by whoever can unlock it. In our P2PKH hash example, the locking script requires that the users that want to spend from a previous transaction output must prove that they possess the private key that hashes to a specific address. For this reason, the script is called scriptpubkey. To make unlocking and locking scripts work in tandem, we simply concatenate them. We put the unlocking script on top of the locking script, scriptsig on top of scriptpubkey, and then run them together. And the entire resulting script must execute successfully in order for the transaction to be considered valid.